heard of celiac sprue disease? A lot of people haven't, but studies show that there are actually about 2 million people in this country who have the condition. And to put it simply, it's a condition where people just can't tolerate gluten, which is in pretty much everything. It's a protein in wheat, rye, and barley, and it's in so many common foods and everyday products, so it's an issue. Finding new gluten-free items can be tough, but this morning we have some suggestions for you. Two women to tell us about a gluten-free event that is happening today. Debbie Paul and Diane Craig, thanks for coming in. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
You know, I had never heard of celiac disease until Elizabeth Hasselbeck, who's on The View and was on Survivor, she found out that she had it through the course of doing the reality show because her body kind of got starved. So she wasn't eating a lot of the things that she normally ate. Is that, well, obviously going on reality TV, not the best way to find out about that, but how do most people discover that they have it? Because you were 37 before you knew.
That's right. There are over 300 symptoms associated with celiac disease.
Mm-hmm. And such as?
Oh, anemia. Premature osteoporosis, infertility for women. They range all over the map, but only about half of the people have gastrointestinal symptoms, and those range all over the map, too.
Okay, and did you have similar types of feelings? You were a little bit younger when you found out.
Yeah, I was in my college years, and I pretty much had, like, brain fog. It can, you know, really start causing neurological effects. And so I was just having some thinking problems and digestive problems. And my husband's mother is celiac as well. And so she kind of talked me through the diet and the diagnosis process.
Interesting. All right. So these are some of the products that you can find. Is it getting a little bit easier to find some of these products now? I mean, like, here's a box of Chex, which I think most people are familiar with. And now it's gluten-free.
Right.
Does it make that much of a difference?
It's a huge difference. General Mills, this is a new mainstream product for them. There used to be barley in all the Chex cereals, mm-hmm. and they have taken it out. And so, but you need to look and make sure that the product on the shelf does say gluten-free, because this is brand new.
Okay. This is a basket full of all kinds of stuff. There are actually some great products for kids, too.
Right. That's one of the new things. This is something that when our children were little, we didn't have animal crackers to feed our celiac children. Mm-hmm. And so I really love to see all the products that are especially for children these days. That helps a lot.
What's another interesting thing in here that you find really useful? Because, I mean, I can't imagine having to eliminate all these different foods from your diet.
Well, one of the things that's really won't be at our fair, but it's appropriate for the hot weather, gluten-free beers are a fairly new item. It used to be a little difficult, especially for some guys, to think about becoming diagnosed as celiac,
right.
because regular beer has, again, barley in it.
Sure. Okay. How about one more from there?
Okay.
This is a new and interesting sauce we have here. It's called, I'm part owner of the company, it's Ole's Products. It's a sweet and spicy sauce. A lot of the condiments have gluten in it. And so our company does a lot of sauces to help people be able to still enjoy them.
And so you can add these to some of the other things
sure.
that you might be eating, make it taste a little bit.
Yeah, it's a great meat marinade and
okay.
Over rice, really versatile.
Well, you know, it's great that there are more options. And I noticed that just even shopping in the grocery store now, you see it a lot more on the label. So that's got to be great news for both of you.
It really is.
Okay, great. Well, if you want to learn more about this, the gluten-free fair is going on today. It starts at 10. It's going until 2 p.m. Mm-hmm. And it's taking place at the St. Mark's Fellowship Hall in Sacramento, and that's over near Watt and El Camino. Admission is just $1. Okay, well, that's nice. Thanks for keeping that affordable in this economy. We appreciate it.
We wanted to encourage people to come.
And I think that will really help, and lots of great suggestions for people. Thanks very much, and good luck with the fair today.